Hello, hello, hello. Are we live? It looks like Twitch is live and Facebook is live. Okay. It always takes a few seconds. I pressed the button about like 5 minutes ago. Let me get the Facebook up here on my phone. And I'll be able to read some comments if we have any technical difficulties. How's everybody getting on? Let me know where you're all tuning in from. And YouTube is live, Jason says. Nice one. Looks like we're live on all the platforms. Let me see, can I get it here on my phone? Yes. Yeah, how's everyone getting on? It's another scorcher of a day here. It's getting hotter and hotter every Wednesday that I'm doing these classes. I had to have a cap on today because the heat was getting too much and the hair was getting too messy. I need this isolation to be over so I can get a haircut. But we've got a few people saying hello from South Africa. Rainy in Nottingham, Cathal, but ready to dance in Flip's Dance School. Oh, wow, it's Nottingham. Jeez, it's raining over there. It's absolutely beautiful here today. Carol asked on Facebook. Someone says, hello, Maggie. Hello, Maggie. Hope you're doing well. Someone is watching from Manchester. Jade, what's the weather like in Manchester? Apparently, it's raining in Nottingham. Gem543 said, Cathal, how are you getting on, Gemma? I'm going to call you Gemma. So welcome, everybody. So what we're going to do today. So we started something new last week. It was called Cathal Keaney's Cathal's Trick of the Day, or Flip's Tricks. So what we're doing is every day, we're going to start off these streams where exactly Carol just said there, Flip's Tricks. Flip's Tricks are Cathal's Trick of the Day. So we're going to start all these streams off with, I'll teach you a new trick, basically, the trick of the day. And it'll be something a little bit different. So it'll be something that's not from Lord of the Dance, okay? It'll be a move that's not from Lord of the Dance. It will be something not very traditional, so it'll be a bit more tappy. I'm muffling my words there, a bit more tap-like. And the goal is we're going to learn a trick every single week that's a little bit different. And in a few weeks' time, live on a stream like this, we're going to put together a live a cappella solo. I think an a cappella will work best besides me trying to play music through this. And you guys can be telling me, we'll just see what happens. You guys can be telling me what to do or what steps to put in. But that's the goal. So, and obviously when we're making up this solo in a few weeks' time, we'll be throwing in a lot of traditional stuff and moves from Lord of the Dance. But the goal for this trick of the day is going to be every week we'll learn something a little bit funky, a little bit different. And yeah, so that's what we start off these streams with. And then the next thing we'll do is we'll learn some steps from the show. Obviously, this is Lord of the Dance, so why not learn some of the dances from the show? This week, I'm going to leave it up to you guys to let me know what you want to learn. I'll read a few comments before they disappear off my screen. Hello from Luxembourg, Nicholas says. Weather is changing at the moment. Okay, looks like the weather is changing a bit east from Ireland. It's really sunny here in Ireland. On YouTube, Stephen Murray says, watching from Derry City, Irish dance, 3 years. Nice one. The trick of the day today is going to be easy. I'm going to talk about it a little bit more in a second. And someone says it's cloudy here in Manchester. Okay. And hello from Croatia. Wow, nice. Absolutely loved Croatia. A few suggestions already coming in. Yes, so this week, for the second half of this stream, we'll learn some of the steps from the show. So let me know whatever steps you want to learn today. I'm going to do whatever you guys want. Usually I'll come in with a already decided what dance we're going to learn. We've got Gemma asking, can we learn a bit off Robojig and a bit off LOTD? We certainly will. You're the first suggestion in, so we will stick with that unless we have any more overwhelming suggestions that more people want to do. But yes, Robojig, looks like Robojig is popular at the moment. And then for the second half of the show, the last half of the show, we'll play the game Guess the Dance. So Guess the Dance, basically I cover the webcam here and I'll go up on my portable spunk floor and I'll dance a couple of bars from one of the numbers in the show. And by just listening, you guys have to try guess what that dance is. We've been doing this for the last few weeks and everyone seems to love it. So that is the schedule for today. Anyone who's new to this, we're live streaming on three different platforms. So right now we're live on YouTube, we're live on Twitch, and we're live on Facebook. So yeah, three different platforms we've got people watching in. I've got the Twitch comments up here on my screen. Jason, he'll forward any comments from YouTube or Facebook over to me here so I can read them. And I also got it open on my phone, so just in case if anything goes wrong. I'll read a few more comments here. Breezy and wet in Southport, loving these live streams. Yes, we got a good a packed live stream today for you. Good evening, Carl. How are you today? I'm very well, Sarah. Hope you're keeping well. And we've got a few people tuning in from Czech Republic. We've got some people from California. Nice. That must be quite early over there. So yeah, let's talk about today's trick that we're going to be learning. So I was thinking about what trick will I teach you today? Let me just see. Someone says, how come your brother doesn't dance the part of Lord anymore? Because he's not in the show, Morgan asked over on Facebook. Yeah, my brother, that's in there on the poster. Fergal Keaney is his name. Poster's a little bit slanted today. I better fix it. But he was in the show. He danced lead in the show for years, but he's not in the show anymore. He retired from dancing. And over on YouTube, someone asked, hello from Argentina. Wow. Nice one. I was saying, so today's trick of the day, I've got a fun one for you. It's actually going to be probably one of the easiest tricks that we're going to learn, but I think it's one of the most important tricks you will learn. So basically, different dancers call them different things, but everyone has their go-to, whatever they call their efficient dance move or their recovery dance move or their basically just their go-to dance move. It's usually a really simple rhythm pattern that people just tend to go to when they're stuck for something to do or if they're in the middle of a solo or middle of a dance and they're trying to get their breath back. I call them energy recovery steps. So just your energy recovery steps. A good example of one that lots of dancers do, I'm sure you'll all recognize this one. This is a very good step that a lot of people just go to, yeah? So that is an example of a very basic, just a go-to energy recovery dance, 16 bars, that I'm sure you've all seen that. That's actually in Lord of the Dance, and a lot of dancers use that one. Basically, what it is just an 8-bar step that you can just do quickly. You don't even have to think about it. It's super easy. The rhythm is very repetitive, so you don't have to be thinking too much, and you throw them into dancers here and there, usually to get your breath back. Or if you've just done a really tricky section, you've done a couple of really tricky moves, and you know sometimes you just need to let that sink into the audience's mind, so you'll fall back into your easy energy recovery step. So today we're going to learn a different one. That's a good one, but that's your very typical Irish dance one. I'm going to teach you one that me and my brother used to do a lot. It's a bit more low to the ground. I think it's a lot more funky. It's a lot easier to do as well, believe it or not. Even though it might look harder, it's a lot easier to do. And we used to stick it in our dances all the time to just, when you're just trying to get a moment to get your breath back, it's nice and simple. It's a repetitive beat that you can just go to whenever you're stuck for. If you've just done a big tricky section and you want to get your breath back, you can do it. If you're just looking for a bit to slow down the routine or the number that you're doing, you can go back to this. And I'll show you, this is the move that I'm going to show you today for Flip's Tricks. So, like I said, it's going to be super easy, but it's also going to be super important because, like I said, a move like this, an energy recovery, super easy go-to step like this, you can just throw it in anywhere in your dance. So this one, it's even easier than doing that. That's every Irish dancer's go-to move at the moment when they're in the middle of their acapellas. But this one is actually even easier. And it's a bit more loose and a bit more down, and it's a bit more tappy. So that's what we do here at Flip's Tricks, something a little bit different. And it will look like this. Yes. So that is the Flip's Tricks I'm going to show you today. And like I said, this is I'd call this like an energy recovery move. You'd be in the middle of a big acapella. You'd have just done some really cool, crazy tricks. You're really out of breath and you're just looking for, you just need a couple of moments, a couple of bars just to get your breath back. and you bust into something like this. I personally think that step is a lot better than going into the usual, a lot of dancers call the first one I was doing, the shit step. Just because it's a little bit different. Everyone knows this one. But even that does take a bit of energy because it's very, because it is still traditional Irish dance moves, you kind of have to have your legs crossed for it to look good, you know? If I didn't cross my legs on that when I'm trying to get my breath back in the middle of a solo or something, that just looks a little bit weird. So even though this is a lot of Irish dancers' go-to recovery step or go-to move in the middle of a dance, it still takes a little bit of energy out of you. That's why I like to do this one. Okay? And the reason I really like this step that I'm going to teach you is because you can do it lots and lots of different ways. You could have just after doing a really hard section, lots of tricky moves like... Lots of different ways you can do that move. So that is the one we're going to learn today. And like I said, in a few weeks' time, we're going to stick all these flips tricks together, along with a lot of actual traditional Irish dance moves that you will all recognize. And I think having something like this, we will definitely need to stick it into the solo after we do some hard bits to get our breath back. So let me read a few comments before I break down this move. This one is super, super easy, okay? Super, super easy, and I'll show you in a second. You can throw in hands and really jazz it up a little bit, and it'll be a great step to learn. It's a little bit funky. People will be like, oh, that's a bit different than your usual Irish dancing steps, and you can throw it into any of your steps to really just help get your breath back before you smash into the next bit of it. I usually like to stick it in the middle of a solo or something. And let's read a few comments here. We got hello from California on Facebook. Morris, how come your brother... Oh. No, I think the stream here, Jason, is broken again for some reason. Oh, no. Well, don't worry. I have it here on Facebook. So if you want to go over to Facebook, yep, yeah, Jason's already on top of it. Someone says, good morning, my friend. Simone says, hello from Brazil. Oh, you were meant to be going to Brazil. Welsh lad is in the chat room. Welsh lad is full of the knowledge. He knows more about the show than I do. He says, anyone else worried for the... fireplace at times. Don't worry, I'm dancing on the floor here, so I'm not touching the fireplace. But yes, well, lad, I'll keep that in mind. Let me scroll. I think I missed a few. Sarah Wakefield says, is there any footage of you dancing these kind of steps with your brother? That'd be so much fun. Believe it or not, Sarah, there actually is. Recently, I just shared something on my Facebook page. And this exact step, believe it or not, that I'm going to teach you, me and my brother, we break into it. So... I shared a video on my Facebook page. It's an acapella that me and my brother and some other young lads join in with us at the end. Colin Keneally, fantastic world champion dancer as well. But if you want to see us breaking into a step like this, you'll see us in the middle of that. It's an acapella that we're dancing. I think we're dancing for 2 minutes. That mightn't sound like a long time, but trust me, for us dancers, that's a long time. And halfway through the solo, we break into this energy recovery step that I'm going to teach you. I don't even know what to call it. I'll just call it your go-to simple step to get your energy back, basically. I'll read a few more comments and then we'll get into learning it. A big shout out to my uncle if he's watching, Stephen Keeney. He lives over in London. Someone says, hello, my question disappeared up on the screen. How come your brother... Oh, sorry. I'm repeating a lot of questions. And someone says, hello from Australia. It's 3:18 in the morning. Wow. On Thursday, you're a day ahead of us. Tell us what the future's like over in Australia. Oh, and it looks like the Twitch comments are back. Welsh lad, our very own Lord Appella. Yes, exactly. So I'll just repeat myself one more time before we get stuck into this, okay? For anyone who might have just tuned in right there. What we're doing is, on these streams, these are live dance classes with me, Cathal Keaney, Lord of the Dance. What we do, we start off each dance class with a trick a day. Flips tricks, we often call it, some of the fans call it. But basically, I'm going to teach you a move That's not very traditional. It's not from the show Lord of the Dance. Something you probably won't have learned from your dance class. It's all about fun here. Learn something a little bit different. And that's how we start off the stream learning that. The trick of the day. And the goal is we learn a few of these tricks. And down the line on one of these live streams, we're going to make up a live solo where we'll stick in. Obviously, we need some traditional dance moves in there. But we'll stick in a few of these moves. Today's move is a nice, simple energy recovery move that will probably stick in the middle of a solo. If anyone wants to see it in action, I said I shared something on my Facebook a few days ago of me and my brother, and you'll see the step in the middle of it, and you can see how we're using it to get our energy back. Then the second half of the show, we'll learn something from Lord of the Dance. It looks like it might be Robo Jig today. And then the last half, we play this game called Guess the Dance, where I cover the webcam, I dance some steps, and by listening, you guys just have to tell me what dance it's from. Rightio, we're going to get stuck into this trick. Trick of the day is probably going to be the easiest trick. It takes the least amount of effort ever. I can't think of an easier step. Rightio. And Kimberly says, Carl, how was your birthday? My birthday was very good. We had it live here on Twitch, believe it or not. So here we go. The step we're about to learn. I'll do it fast all the way through once, and then I'll break it down. Super fun, super relaxed, and super low to the ground. It's going to be a great step that you can, like I've just demonstrated before, you can throw in to any of your solos. You might have done something really tricky like sitting down. And it's a great step to take it back down a notch. So how do we do it? Super easy. Everyone should try this. I've got the commons up here. So it starts off with a heel, toe. Okay? Okay. I'll do that from behind. So, heel and toe. And then we got someone saying, hello from France. Wow. Okay, again, the start of this step. This is, like I said, this is the easiest step. I recommend everyone to give it a go. So, go heel, toe. So, you put the foot down and toe. And everything about this step is about conserving energy, okay? Remember, this step, you know, we're not trying to cross our legs or anything like that. This is a step where when we're absolutely knackered in the middle of a dance, but we still want to prolong the dance, make the dance go on for longer. We just need a couple of seconds to get our breath back. We go into it something like this. So remember, this is all about just being loose, low to the ground. You don't have to worry about crossing your legs. You can have your upper body nice and loose. And it's so simple that, you know, you do this for maybe 8 bars or 16 bars and you'll have enough energy back to finish the rest of the solo. And it's a good little rest piece for any in the middle of any dance. So back to learning it. Heel, toe, okay? Do that twice. So do that twice. Heel, toe, heel, toe. Can't get any simpler than that, right? There's no shuffles. We're not up on our toe. We're planted. Our legs are spread. Not very Irish dancey, I told you. Lips tricks is very non-traditional, okay? So we're nice and loose, and we're just going to go heel, toe, heel, toe, okay? That's the first bit. Try that fast. Heel, toe, heel, toe. Heel, toe, heel, toe. Okay? So that is the very first bit of it. So the next bit we're going to go over onto our left leg. So think about it. What is the most efficient way to get? So all our weight's on the left leg. We're going heel, toe, heel, toe. The right leg. So we do it twice. We need to get to the left leg. What is the most efficient way to do that? So very traditional Irish dance steps would have us up on our toe. And we'd probably have done, instead of going heel toe, we probably would have gone shuffle, shuffle, and then we would jump. And like I said, this step's all about conserving energy, so we're nice and low to the ground. We're going to go heel toe, heel toe. Now we got to put the weight from the left to the right. So the best way is just to go tip, okay? Tip and heel. We could just go like this. But if we just do that, that took the same amount of effort as going like this. And like, by doing the landing with the toe first and then the heel, it's the same amount of effort as just going like this, but we're getting one extra beat. Do you hear it? It goes one, two, instead of going one. So let's just do it up to there. So it starts off with heel, toe, heel, toe, step, heel. Okay? And that step heel, just fall down onto it. Just think about it.
think about, I'm just changing my weight from my left leg to my right leg. I want to do it the most efficient way as possible. Remember, we're doing, it's not a very traditional dance move here. So we're trying to save as much energy as possible, but also make as many beats as we can. So instead of just going like this, we're going to go, okay? And that way we get two beats instead of one. Let me just check the chat room here. How's everyone getting on? Hello from Bulgaria. We've got people saying it's rainy here in Missouri. Oh my God, it looks like Galway for once has the sunniest weather. Nice one. Everyone keep practicing that. Toe, heel, step. Okay? We've got hello from France. Kimberly says hello. How are you getting on, Kimberly? What makes you fall in love with Irish dancing? What made me fall in love with Irish dancing? The truth, when I was a kid, it was actually Lord of the Dance, believe it or not. I used to watch it on cassette tape with my brother. That's my broski there, for real. Yeah, so it was actually the show. Right, when we get back to the step, this is probably the easiest step you're ever going to learn. That actually kind of looks cool, if that makes any sense at all. So we've gone heel, toe, step. Okay? Heel, toe, step. And just do it slow first. And the key to doing this is make it as effortless as possible. So don't really exaggerate going heel, toe, step. Because that's too much energy. Remember, this is an energy saver move that will stick in the middle of a solo, but we still need to keep the rhythm going. So do it as relaxed as possible. Okay. And then we're just going to do the same thing after we've gone step heel on the left leg. Heel, toe, step, heel. From behind. Heel, toe, step, heel, toe. Okay. So just keep trying that. I don't really know how to simplify it down anymore. I think that's pretty simple. Heel, toe, step. Heel, toe, heel, toe, step. Heel, toe, heel, toe, step. Heel, heel, toe, heel, toe, step. So yeah, that is basically it. Now, if we want to put a little bit of a rhythm pattern to it, as Jason likes to call them, this is a very simple rhythm. You could do whatever you want, but this is what I tend to do. So I'll dance. I have to kind of dance this a little bit faster, sorry. But this is what I tend to do. I'll do two on this leg. Two on this leg, one. And then I'll change it just to a single one. So, sorry, I have to do it a bit fast. So it'll go like this. Okay, sorry, I did explain that when I explained it kind of wrong. So what I do, I go two, one. And then I just do one on this leg. So the rhythm pattern we're going to learn today is just two on this leg, two on this leg, one on the right leg. And then we go two, two, one. So it goes two, two, one, two, two, one, two, two, one. And then we'll finish with like one, 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 one. So I'll try to explain it as best as I can here. I kind of have to do it at medium speed, but it goes like this. Two, two, one, two, two. Any questions? To break down what it is again, for anyone who's just tuned in, the step is heel, toe, step, heel. Heel, toe, step, heel. And the rhythm pattern we're doing, we're just going to go heel, toe, step. Heel, toe, step, heel. Heel, toe, step, heel, heel, toe. Okay? So, at the start, just keep practicing. And just keep doing that for a long time. So get that bit first, and then we can go into like, oh, let's kind of change it up. Maybe only do one on the right leg. But the step is the same, even if you just do one. It's the same step. All it is heel, toe, but then you just change over to the other leg. You practice that for a second, and I'll read some comments.
Rightio. Let me see. Cathal, you are one of the lords who has had the opportunity to wear an original Michael Flatley Lord of the Dance belt. Yes, I am. I can't believe I got that opportunity. It's the gold one that we sometimes, obviously each tour is different. We have different costumes that go around the world, but if anyone watches the show, it's the run-on one that's gold. Quick poll, who's enjoying the non-traditional flips, tricks, moves? Yes, let me know. I'm enjoying them. It's something different, I think. And like I said, this is all building up to putting together a solo, okay? And why are we doing this move? You might say, oh, this looks a bit easy or it looks simple. This is going to be a go-to move that we're going to need to stick in the middle of a solo. Solos can't be hell for leather. Even Michael Flatley's Feet of Flame solos, you know, he's going along doing all his fast things and then he stops and he goes... That's super easy, but you need these things to keep the audience engaged. So the move that I'm teaching right now, I think it's one of the simplest. It keeps a rhythm going because you obviously don't want to stop too long in a solo or in a dance, but it keeps a rhythm going where you and gives you your chance to get your breath back. I suppose I'll demonstrate here how you could do it, and you can keep practicing that heel toe. But it's also a great move. If you're just trying to freestyle and you've got some music on, you know, you've got some music on, you just kind of start bopping around the place. You just want to stay low. Yeah, and you can just mess around. Like I said before, you can make so many different rhythm patterns by just going heel, toe, heel, toe. Yeah, that's all we're doing. Heel, toe, and then, to change the weight, we just go step. So... all you gotta know for this is heel toe to change leg, step, and then you can do whatever you want. You can do a 3-on-1 leg. The possibilities are endless. You can even start it nice and slow. The old hands in the pockets. Your hands for this one as well. So let me read a few comments. How's everyone getting on with flips tricks today? Please let me know if anyone's struggling. I think it's quite an easy one today. I'll read a few comments. Let me know if anyone wants me to break it down a bit. If not, I guess we'll just jam out with it for a little bit. We'll practice it together. We'll jam out. Oh yeah, actually I'll show you a really simple rhythm. The one I like to do, what is it? Two. 2-2, so it's 2-2-1, 2-2-1, 2-2-1, 1-1-1-1. That probably makes no sense me talking it, but that I'll show you now. That's the rhythm pattern that I kind of like to do. It's the easiest one. We've got Croswood says, hello, Cathal. Hello, how are you getting on? I would like to learn that. Someone says they'd like to learn it. Please learn it. I'll break it down one more time, and then we're going to... jam out with it for a little bit, learn a simple rhythm pattern, and then we're going to get stuck into some Lord of the Dance steps. I'll have a look here on the Facebook. Someone says you are the best. Well, thank you very much. Someone says, hello, I'm living in Spain, but I am from Ireland. Nice one. Rodriguez Doyle. Hi, Cathal. I'm in West London. My mum and dad are Irish and love Ireland. Nice. Hope you're getting on well, Denise, and hope you're trying this Cathal Keaney's trick of the day today. It's a very, very easy one. Super easy, great energy saver move to stick in any dance. Rightio. On Facebook, I love watching Dance for Hope on YouTube. Great seeing some of the earlier cast members. They still got it brilliant. Yes, the Dance for Hope videos, they seem to have gone down well. It was great seeing the original cast do it. That was amazing. John Fix, oh, my cousin from New York, when we were over in New York, how long was that? It was 2 years ago, and they came over here to Ireland as well. John Fix says, hey cousin, watching from New York, can't wait for you and the show to make it back to New York. Yes, John, hope you're keeping well. I know the coronavirus is pretty bad in New York for a while, wasn't it? So I hope everything's good there now and you got it under control. Someone says hello from Bulgaria. Hello. Hope you're keeping well. Anyways, back to the dancing. Where in Ireland are you from, Cathal? I am from Galway, the west coast of Ireland. The best bit of Ireland. Hope I didn't annoy anyone by saying that, but it is. So here we go. We're nearly finished. Flips tricks of the day. If anyone has any questions, no one has really said they were stuck on it. So, yeah, I think it's quite easy. We'll break it down one more time. We've got a few people saying hello from Germany. That's I already read that one. In Ireland, where am I from? I'm from the west. So, rightio. Back to the trick of the day. Like I said, it's quite a simple one. I'll do it fast once. I'll break it down again. And then we'll learn a quick rhythm pattern. We'll jam out for a little bit. Keep it nice and loose. Loosey-goosey. And, yeah, we'll see how we go. So this was the simple trick that we learned today. Super fun, super easy. It's a great step. Rightio. Let's break it down one more time. So how do we do that step? Super easy. It starts off with heel, toe, heel, toe, step, heel. It doesn't get any easier than that, okay? And if we're only doing it once on the leg, like I'm sure when you've seen that rhythm pattern, sometimes I just went and I kept changing leg. All that is if you just do one heel, toe, step, change, okay? And we're doing it twice on one leg, heel, toe, step, change. When I say we just do it once, we just do heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Okay? So very easy. You could even do three. The rhythm pattern I'm going to do, we won't do three, but you could do three. You could do as many as you want. So, again, I'll do it from behind. Heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Now let's just do one on each leg. Heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Let's go for two. Heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Let's go for one. Heel, toe, step, change. Let's go for two again. Heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, step, change. Let's go for one. Heel, toe, step, change. Okay? You're all getting the idea, yeah? I just got to tighten up my floor. Let's see. Any comments? Ashwa says, hey, Cathal, what made you fall in? Oh, I already read that one. Some of these comments are a bit delayed coming in. And we had to convert our air conditioning to Fahrenheit to Celsius. Yes, we use Celsius here. I think it's only the States that use Fahrenheit. Okay, rightio. Let's do this simple rhythm pattern. So when I say two, that just means we're going to go. And when I say one, that just means you go. Okay, does that make sense? So two is, it's kind of hard to talk and dance, but when I say two, that's. Okay, I'm doing two on each leg. When I say one, it's just. Okay, so the rhythm pattern we're going to do is going to be two, two, one, two, two, one, two, two, one, and then we're just going to finish it off with one, 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 and then we repeat it again. I hope that doesn't sound too confusing, but this is what that looks like. So go two, two, one, two, two, one, two, two, one, 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 one. Okay, let me know if anyone wants me to explain that any better. So it's like two, 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 one, two. Make sense if I hold up my hand? Okay, who wants to jam out with it for a little bit? We'll start off nice and slow and we'll each go we'll try build up the speed. So when we're finishing with the one, then we just start back into the whole thing again. Two, two. And
And each repetition, each new 8 bars, you'll be starting on the opposite leg. So we start with the left leg, with the right leg, sorry. But when we do that, we'll be now starting with the left leg. Okay, so let's jam out with this for a little bit, okay? See if anyone has any questions. Someone's from Wexford, hello. From New Ross. Barbara shared the live stream. Saw your colleague this morning on Facebook cooking and doing yoga. Yes. So here we go. We'll start off nice and slow, whoever's ready. Remember, the step is just heel, toe, okay? Sometimes we do it twice like that, heel, toe, step, change. And sometimes we just do it once, heel, toe, step, change. And that's all the step is. We do it on the right and the left leg. So here we go, nice and slow first. 3, 2, 1, go. A bit of fun. Rightio, let me read a few of the comments. Super easy move, I think, guys, yeah? We do that one more time, jam out to that again. Remember, it's just, we do two, so two right leg, two left leg, then once. Two left leg, two right leg, then once. Two right leg, two left leg, then once, and then just singles all the way to the end. One, 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 one. Someone says, I can't do it barefoot. To be honest, I was jamming out in the kitchen earlier on in my bare feet doing it. You might want to do it for too long because you could hurt yourself. I mean, the skin on the bottom of your feet might get sore, but Jason, I'm sure you can do this. Definitely. I think everyone can do this. Mary Jo Pro says, hey, Carl, how are you? I am very, very good. I'm very good today. Who wants to go back? Will we jam out with this again? Flips tricks. Super easy one today, guys. I think it sounds fun, it's nice and easy. Keep it loose, keep it fun. For anyone who's just joined, okay, I don't want to waste everyone's time going over again, but all it is just heel, toe, heel, toe, step, change. Heel, toe, heel, toe, step, change. A single one is heel, toe, step, change. And that's the whole thing learned. And I'll try my best to shout out two and singles. Two just means you go. So they're both twos, and a single would be this. Okay? Someone says, putting on a pair of heels. Yes, put on a pair of heels and try. You can definitely do this in heels. Maybe not that one in heels. But here we go. Let's jam out to this again. Super fun. Super fun move. Here we go. Remember, it's not a traditional dance move. Really sit down into it, okay? It's a bit more tappy-like. Here we go. So I'll try shout it out when I'm talking. I don't know if you can hear me when I'm shouting it, but here we go. We're going to start off with two on the right leg. Here we go. Two. And that is the end of Flipper's Trick of the Day.
Oh, God. That was fun. Yeah, I didn't really get any questions, so I think everyone got that. It is super easy, I think, like I was telling you guys. And for anyone who might have just joined us, what we're doing here, we start off every stream with a Trick of the Day, Flipper's Tricks. And I'll just like, so I'll read this comment. Sarah says, you mentioned that a two-minute dance is tough. This step is supposed to be an energy saver. How long do you think you could do it non-stop for? To be honest with you, I was jamming out there for a little bit, and I'm not that sweaty. But when I was doing the other steps, I was getting really, really sweaty. When we go, we're going to move on to Robojig now, learn something from the actual show, Lord of the Dance. You'll see I'll be sweating a lot easier. That a step like that, I think, is very important for every dancer to have. The usual energy saver step, like I mentioned at the start, that most Irish dancers go for, is this one. That's the most common. You'll see every Irish dancer in every show, even if they're just jamming out, like doing a cappella and stuff, you'll always throw in that step, and you usually throw them in when you're kind of getting tired. You've been doing all these tricks like... And then you go into an easy step. But why not go into this? It's even easier. You can get your energy back. You can have fun with it, okay? So that's why I said this was one of those fun energy saver steps that who asked that? Sarah said that you stick into a solo. I'm sure if you watch Flatley's Feet of Flames, he mightn't do stuff as loose and tappy as that, but in the middle of his solo, you'll see him kind of doing his like... That's basically the same thing. That's Flatley doing an energy saver step. The one I taught you just has a few more beats in it, but it's great to save energy. So sorry, I went on a bit of a ramble there, and the goal is... So we learn a new trick every day that's not really traditional, a bit more tappy, a bit different here on the Trick of the Day at the start of these streams. And then a few weeks' time, we're going to make up a solo live where you guys will be telling me what to do, and we'll throw in a few of these tricks that we've learned over the weeks. And we'll see how that'll go. That'll be a bit of fun. But yeah, we're going to leave that. That's the end of Flip's Tricks for the Day. Let me read a few comments. Asked, do you drink tea? Yes, I drink tea. Some very interesting comments coming in here. Yes, I drink tea. When I say robo, you say jig. Robo jig. Yes, Gemma. Come up with your own little chant there. You can add that in onto the Haindo 3 car. Denise says, that was exhausting. You can feel it in your legs. Oh my God. Yeah, like it might get a... If you're not used to it, you might find it hard. But trust me, most Irish dancers who've danced a while, they'll try that and be like, wow, that was super easy, super fun. And I'm sure they'll start sticking into their dances or their exhibitions or whatever you want to call it. Gabriella says, hi, Carl. Greetings from Prague and the kitchen as well. Hello from the kitchen. The last week's trick killed me. Yes, last week's trick. What was that again? This was last week's trick. Last week's trick. That was last week's trick, wasn't it? Brush shuffles. They're a little bit hard. But I'm. Let me know if you got it, Gabrielle, from Prague. Someone on YouTube says it's always nice to see you. Greetings from Holland. Righty-o. So guys, we'll leave that bit there for today. Let me know what dance from Lord of the Dance do you want to learn today. I might give you a few seconds, because I know I'm on a little bit of a delay, to write in what you want me to learn. I know someone already mentioned. Robojig, so we'll do that. We'll see if there's any more suggestions come in. Robojig is straight in there. I think it's got to be Robojig. I'll give you another minute or two to write in your suggestions, and then I'll teach you whatever you want, guys. You're controlling me. It's like an episode of Black Mirror. Did anyone see that one where you get to come, you pick what you want the characters to do? Choose what dance you want me to do. Product placement. Yes, product placement while everyone is getting their suggestions in, but it looks like it will be Robojig. What is this I am dancing on? It is a portable sprung Irish dance floor. You can go check them out on Facebook, on Instagram. But what is it? The name pretty much says it all. It's a portable sprung dance floor. So ask Irish dancers, what do you want to dance on? we do a lot of banging into the ground, so we want to have a little bit of give, yeah? So if we're dancing on a hard surface like these tiles, you'll get repetitive stress injuries like shin splints and stuff. And that's not good, you know, because we're pounding the ground the whole time. So we want to, like in Lord of the Dance, we dance on a sprung floor. Not everyone has a sprung floor at home. It's expensive, and even if you did have the money, you might want to do up your sitting room like this with a whole sprung floor. The tiles look nice, right? So this is something you can put together. It comes in two halves. You can attach it together. I'll have my little dance platform here that I'm jamming out on. It's sprung. You can kind of see here. It has a bit of give in it. The shock absorber is under it, so that'll take some of the impact. And I'm banging the ground like that, so that will take some of the impact forces, take it out of my shins and my bones, and it'll disperse it into the floor. Then it's also made out of really good high quality wood, because it sounds great. I think you all agree. So it sounds good. And then on top of it, what is that blue thing on top? You might have said you've seen other colors, but that is a non-slip surface. So while wood sounds great, wood isn't always good to dance on. Why? Because wood wears really quickly. You know, when you're dancing on for a long time, it just sometimes you're basically polishing it. It might get slippy. Then every now and then you dig your heel in, and when you dig your heel in, you're going to put dents in it. So us Irish dancers, I'm sure if you've ever seen any Lord of the Dance videos, our surface is a grey surface that we dance on. This is a blue one. It's a non-slip polymer overlay. So altogether, you've got your non-slip surface on top of it, so you won't be slipping. It will last long. You've got plenty of grip to do your Irish dancing moves. You've got the wood, which sounds great. It's a raised floor, so the acoustics will make it even sound better. And then you've got your shock absorbers underneath, absorbing all that impact. So that is what I'm dancing on. Let's catch up on these questions. I'm 51 years old, young. Seriously, want to take up Irish dancing? Give it a go. We had an easy trick at the start of this. Denise says, definitely robo jig. Definitely robo jig. Okay, there's a lot of robo jig coming in. Gabrielle says, let's do warriors. Okay. We've done warriors before, or robo jig. Okay. I've got a wooden floors, I feel, for my neighbors. Yes. Even if you have wooden floors at home, your dance shoes will wreck them, trust me. Yeah, they will. Rightio. Robo jig, robo jig. So it looks like you want me to teach you robo jig. Quick question for you guys. Another one of Flatley's shows. What is the number, the steps from robo jig? I didn't explain that very well. The steps in robo jig are also from another number in a different Michael Flatley show. What is the number? I explained it better that second time. Okay, it looks like it's robo jig. Let's get stuck right in. Robo jig's a hard one now, guys. Thank God we don't have the robo jig costumes today, because we would be sweating in the heat. This is the key that helps lock the floor. Okay, so robo jig, what is the first step? It's been a while since I've danced robo jig. It's this, isn't it? So I think that's the first step, isn't it? You guys tell me. I'm the Lord of the Dance, I should know, shouldn't I? When I'm put on the spot, you always doubt yourself. Any Irish dancers out there will know what I'm talking about. When you have to break down steps, you start doubting yourself. But yeah, that's the very first step in robo jig, guys. Okay, I'll break it down, don't worry. I won't be able to break down the triple click. Oh yes, and people are saying, cry the Celtic Tiger, Redcoats. Yes, these steps are also from Redcoats. Sorry, I forgot I asked you that question. Yeah, well done. Redcoats is the answer. Robo jig is the first dance in the second half where a few of the boys are dressed as robos, and now since Taiwan, some warlords are dancing. That is true. We've changed it up a bit. Yes, everyone got that one right. It's Redcoats. Well, let's learn it. And keep watching my face. Remember I said about that last step I was doing? The Cathal's trick, and I call it an energy saver. And it might look like it's really hard, but I wasn't really sweating. I'm going to start sweating now once I start teaching this robo jig. And they might look just as hard as each other. That's why it's always important to have one of those energy saver steps I taught you at the start in your arsenal to throw out when you're getting tired in the middle of a solo. So here we go. Robo jig. We start off with a 2-footed jump. Okay?
So there's just one beat there. We're not going like this. Land, land. We're landing together with our both legs. So jump. And we're going into what we call a double click. It's a double click. I can't slow this down. Unfortunately, I might be the lord of the dance, but gravity still affects me, so I can't slow down in the air. But basically, we're going to go jump. You're going to use that to spring you up, and you're going to go hit, hit, and do a cut, okay? So like I said, I can't slow that bit down when it goes jump. That's the very first bit of the step. So from behind, two legs, jump. Okay, I'll find it hard to cross my legs now after doing all that fun tappy stuff at the start of the stream. So here we go, legs crossed in front of each other, and we're going to go jump. And that's just one beat, okay? The next one is a double click, so we're just going to jump in the air, and we're going to go hit, hit, and do a cut. So it goes like this. And after the cut, now we land and make two beats when we land. So we space. Okay, so the first jump was together, but when we after the double click, when we land separately on each leg. So, do you hear that? So when you're jumping in dancing, or when you're landing, you can either make one, if you're just landing on one leg, you can either make one beat, or you can make two beats. Okay? The same thing even if we're using two legs, we can make one beat, three beats, or four beats, or two beats even. So at the start, we're jumping with both legs, but we're only making one beat. Okay? Now after the double click when we're landing, we're going to make two beats. Okay? And we could have made four beats there if we dropped the heels. Okay? And you might say, isn't four beats better than, why don't we add in those drop heels? It's so easy. But it actually wouldn't really sound nice to the rhythm. So if you listen to it, it'd be like, oh, that doesn't sound good. Sometimes it's not good to add an extra beat. Sometimes less is more. But here we go again. The start of this step, jump, 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 jump down. Okay? How's everyone getting on with that? We'll move on from that because I can't slow that down anymore. We'll read a few comments. Is the floor covering called Merrily? Yes, some people call it Merrily. Basically, they're just polymer overlays, okay? I think Merrily is just a brand. So try not to use that word too much. But yeah, Merrily is what most people know it as. A non-slip polymer overlay is the technical term. What's the weather like in Ireland? It is roasting, someone says over on Facebook. Everyone ready to continue on with the rest of these red coat steps from Celtic Tiger or Robo Jig from the Lord of the Dance Dangerous Game? So we've got, the next bit is, so what is that? That's a step, tip, tip, hop, okay? But this is fast. Up until now, we were doing a lot of slower stuff. So this is, so that's fast. Down, tip, tip, hop, that's fast. So, down, tip, tip, hop, go, okay? The difference between that and a shuffle hop back, which we've been doing in a lot more streams, the shuffle hop back is we don't really jump off the back leg. Well, we do at the very end, but a shuffle hop back is tip, tip, hop back. But this is, okay? So it's a lot quicker. How's everyone getting on? Just reading a few comments here, don't worry. Okay, let's continue on. So we've got, okay, we've got up to there, right? Down, tip, tip, hop, jump. So that's jump. Down, tip, tip, hop. Let me know if anyone wants me to stay longer on that, or if anyone wants me to move on. Just write in the anyone in the chats, YouTube, Facebook, or Twitch. Just say, Carl, move on. If you want me to slow down, just be like, Carl, slow down. I won't take it personally. Is that okay for everyone? So, we just danced up to there a few times. We'll try to do it slow, but obviously the double click, we're in the air, we're at the mercy of gravity, we can't slow that down. So, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, just up to there. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. And one more time, and we'll move on. So 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, so after that, tap, toe, toe, we're gonna do a cut with the left leg. Cut down. So that goes, tap, toe, toe, cut down. So this dance is really, really sharp. I'm sure you can already tell why Michael Flatley chose these steps to be in Celtic Tiger. It was red coats, so the guys were dressed up as soldiers. When you think of soldiers, you think of, you know, really sharp movements. Already it's really sharp. And then obviously in Dangerous Games, what do you think about robots? Lots of sharp movements as well. That's my best robot dance. Woo! On Twitch, can you show us the arms you use? Yes, I can show you the arms. They're not too hard, but I would always recommend learning the steps first and getting them good before you throw in hands, because if you try doing them together, it is a bit more confusing. But for this, we started off with a walk. If you want to know the hand, we go 1, 2, and the hand is just here. So the hand is basically here for the first start of the first few bars of the dance. So nice and easy if you want to do the hand. So it goes. But personally, my advice would be, don't worry about the hands for now. The steps is the hardest bit, and you'll just be confusing it by trying to do too much at once.
But Bondi and Frankie are the two robots that get to do their cool dance parts halfway through. Yes, that is true, because they are the best. Yes, it's a hornpipe, yep. You were right. This is a hornpipe. I guess Lord of the Dance are the best dancers in history. Oh, thank you. I'm using jazz shoes to dance. That is absolutely fine. Use whatever you want.
Let's continue on. No one has told me to stop or slow down, so we will continue on. So we've done down, tiddly, toe, put down. So that was down, tiddly, up, toe, put down. I call these cuts, by the way, if anyone's getting confused. So, okay. So let's just dance it up to there 3 times. Up to the first cut. So we've gotten the jump, the double click, cut. And when we land, we do land, land, make 2 beats when we land. And then we go up, tiddly, up, toe, cut down. Okay. Let's just do it up to there. We'll do it twice there. Once from the front and once from behind. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, and from behind. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, who's ready for the next bit? So we got, we're going to do it. So that's it. Cut, tip. We do a tip and we come down off that cut. So, cut, tip, hop, diddly, toe, cut. Okay, everyone got that? So after the down, tip, tip, hop, toe, cut, we got up to there. The next bit is tip, land, okay? So what we're trying to do is we need to get the weight back onto the left leg. So if we just go like this, and we need to make 2 beats. That'd be just 1 beat, so we just go. So that's 2 beats. So fast, it looks like this. So cut, down, tip. Sorry, I'm not explaining that well. It's hard to break it down slow. Cut, so. Tip down. So we do the cut, land, tip down, okay? Does that make sense? I do apologize. Any Irish dancers there will know my pain trying to break stuff down slowly. Let me have a look. Any questions? Kim Lee says, you're riding a horse. You sound like you're galloping. I hope that's a good thing. Radio. Let's have a look at the screen because I don't have Twitch up there.
Did you have an amazing birthday? I did. Radio, let's continue.
So we're going to continue up to the cut, tip, down. Okay.
What reminds you of drum?
Okay. So just up to there. 3, 2, 1, go. And now the next step is the same thing again. Diddly toe cut down. So that's a back treble. I know everyone says something different. I'm saying diddly a lot of the time. So we're going to, after the cut, tip down. That's a tip, tip. So we jump off the left leg. And we do one of those really quick. So like I said, I can't hover in the air, but I'm going to jump off the left leg and do 2 tips on the right. That's all that's happening with my right leg. It sounds like 3 beats. It is 3 beats, but I'm only doing 2 with the right and anyone tell me where the turd beat comes from? It's the land, okay? There. That's why it sounds like three beats. So after the cut. Okay. So let's do, we've got up to the two cuts. Okay. We'll try and do it a bit slower. Three, two, one, go. Okay. From behind. Three, two, one, go. Okay, how's everyone getting on? Let me know if you want me to slow that down anymore. I'll do it once really, really slow, and then one more time, that speed. So start off with a jump with the two legs together, then we do a double click with a cut, and we go land, land. So up to there it goes, jump. Okay, and then the next bit is a down, tip, tip, up, toe, cut, tip, down. Dizzy, double cut, down. Okay, and then fast, it looks like this. Three, two, one, go. Okay. I'll let you practice that for a second. I'll read some comments, and the next bit will be just kind of funky.
Kind of funky, if you ask me. I'm sweating. Let me check what's happening here, guys. We've got a lot of people on Facebook today. A lot of people tuning in. Radio. The rhythm pattern sounds a bit like the start of Encore. Yeah, I guess it kind of does. It caught me out briefly before doing Guess the Dance. Oh yes, because I've done this in Guess the Dance. Rightio, how's everyone getting on with that? Let me know if you have any questions. Let's get the hat back on because my hair is a mess. I need a barber's. I hope everyone is getting that step okay. Jump, double, cut down. Oh, here's a question. Back treble. Does that require a hop on the front? Yes. Yes, it does. It does require a jump. I'll show you that.
So those back trebles, it's a... So I'm jumping off the front leg, but not very high. Just enough. If I jump too high, think about it. This leg won't touch the ground, right? It's just a little hop. I think I actually use the word hop as well. So just a hop. Hop. And treble. So there's three sounds in a treble. Two of them are made with the right leg or the left leg, whichever leg you're doing it on, and the other one is the landing leg. So you kind of jump, even if you're doing two legs. There's three beats there. There's like down, two, two.
Let's read a few comments. Is there a story that Bondi fell off the stage doing Robo Jig and only came out with a cut on his knee? And carrying on as if nothing happened. Yes, this is a cracker of a story. Who asked that? Carol Lord. Yes, and so if anyone knows, there's a guy, Andras, we call him Bondi. He's one of our Hungarian dancers. So this dance in the show, we're wearing their robot costumes, basically. So they're very, very hard to see. I think in some of the live streams on tour, we've gotten Jason with the camera, and he's put it inside the helmet. You're basically looking out through a mesh, so like, imagine crossing your fingers, except it's a lot finer than that. You've got a mesh in front of your face, okay? There's two little red lights inside it, because the audience can see there's the red lights of the robots, but they're obviously some of that light reflecting off the inside, so you're getting pretty blinded. And then you're on stage, and on a good day on stage, it's hard to see. You've got the spotlights in your face, then you've got smoke, because we've got the dry ice, or whatever you want to call it, smoke, dry ice, that's filling the stage. So it is really, really, really hard to see. And then when you're dancing, these helmets, they're just a one-size-fits-all, so they're bouncing over the place. This is how I dance in my Robo Jig costume, believe it or not. So I stick my chin out like this, to stick it into it so it doesn't bounce out as much. So I have there's a little pad, and you can't customize them too much because if anyone knows the show, we're always rotating. People get injured, people do different positions. So like I said, the helmets are kind of one-size-fits-all. So there's a bit of sponge on it, and me personally, I jam my chin into it so it doesn't rock too much. But back to Bondi's story, yes. He was dancing on stage, couldn't see the edge of the stage. It was about maybe a meter and a half tall. Like, it was pretty much the height of me. And he went to walk to the front, because there's a bit in the dance where he walks to the front, and then he falls straight off the stage. Thank God he wasn't hurt. He just had a few little cuts. I guess the costume kind of protected him because it's got a lot of armor on it. But yeah, it was very, very funny. So who asked that? Care Lord. Yes, Bondi once fell off the stage doing this dance. I wish I had something to like demonstrate just how hard it is to see out through those costumes. Yeah, basically there's a mesh in front of you. There's two little red lights inside it reflecting into your own eyes. You've got the spotlights on stage. It's kind of dark as well. And then there's the dry ice. Someone here said, yes, Andrea is his sister. Yes, he's Andras and she's Andrea. We just call him Bondi and we call her Andy. Makes it easier. Someone said, what is the logo on your t-shirt? What is the logo on my t-shirt? Oh, it's over here. It's MP. It's a website called MyProtein, which is a fitness website. And I think they do pretty good gym clothes. So yeah, that's it. It's just from a website called MyProtein. Kimberly asks, I'm currently talking to Elvis Presley's cousin. She says, hi. Wow. You're currently talking to Elvis Presley's cousin. She says, hi. Wait, what? It's pretty amazing. Wow. I'm a bit speechless. Unbelievable. Yes. Gemma says, we've done it backstage, can't do it on stage since somebody's head's in there. Rightio, we get back to the dancing and we'll move on. No one told me to slow down, so we will move on. So where have we gone up to? We've done, that's how far we've gotten up to. This next bit is a bit funky, I'm not gonna lie. When I had to learn this, I thought it was a bit funky, so we've got... So this is... So after that second cut, we do the same thing. Cut, tip, land, okay? Cut, tip, land, and this goes... I don't know how to explain this. It's, so we do, after the second cut... Just like the first cut, land, tip, land. You do a toe with your right leg, which is the back leg, and you go toe, jump. So we're gonna jump the right leg over. And this move, you just kind of fall down. This is when we fall, but land with our toes first and then onto the heel. So it's like, so it sounds like that. So toe, jump. So toe with the right leg, jump, land on the left leg, and then we go tip, heel. Go. Go. Toe, land, tip, heel, toe. Does that make sense? I hope it does. From behind, I'm going to go toe, hop, tip, heel, toe. I've got a little bit of a trap muscle. Sorry, I'm going to have to stretch. Sorry, I've been doing a lot of running recently. My legs are a bit tight. So, after that second cut, so we cut, land, tip, step. We're going to go toe, jump, and land. Okay, that, you just kind of, and then we'll finish with a left leg toe. So all the weight's on the left leg. So the weight's on the left leg, tip, land. We're going to go toe with the right leg, jump, and then obviously you have to land with the left leg. Then you're going to go tip, heel, toe. I do recommend this move easier when you do it actually fast, because it's because you kind of just fall into it. If you can kind of see my body, it's like I'm just kind of going. So it's actually easier doing it fast, but to break it down again, it's toe, hop, tip, heel, toe. That's what it is broken down. Toe, hop, tip, heel, toe. And fast it goes. Let me read a few comments.
Deborah asks, where are you in lockdown? Where am I in lockdown? I am in my house. Where I should be. Do you mean what country? I am in Ireland. Do you ever watch motivational videos? Sometimes if I need motivation, I will. How goes the running? Jason asks. Good. Went for a 10K there yesterday. It was very, very hot. I got it in 41 minutes and 40 seconds. My goal is to get a sub 40 10K. So that means I need to run at a pace of 4 minutes, 4 minutes flat, a kilometer. So my pace yesterday was 4 minutes and 4 minutes and 9 seconds. So I need to cut 9 seconds off each kilometer, which is quite a lot. But yeah, no, it's fun. Just trying to keep healthy here. Deborah says, hello from Malta. Hello from Luxembourg. Big thunderstorm in Luxembourg. Wow. If I saw a guy doing that in the woods, I'd run away. If you saw a guy doing what in the woods? I'm confused. Deborah says, where in Ireland? I'm from Galway. You're trying to place my accent. Yeah, some people say my accent, because I'm on tour with a lot of different dancers from different nationalities, our accents do change quite a lot.
But I am from Galway. How's everyone getting on? Mary says, so two heels and two toes. Yes, a dancing question. Two heels and two toes. Mary, you are right. So it goes, toe, hop, tip, heel, toe. Two heels. No, there isn't two heels though. Because we're. So. No, there's only one heel. Where. What's it? Where we do toe. So one, that's the first toe. Oh, excuse me. Hay fever, don't worry. That's a coronavirus. Hay fever. So sorry, Mary. I'm trying to answer your question here. I'm cracking myself up. So it's a toe. Hop. Step, heel, toe. So there's only one heel actually here. So it goes. That's what that step is like. It's actually quite easy once you get the hang of it. Kind of one of these like where you're kind of falling down on it again. Rightio, how's everyone getting on? Will we dance it up to there? I'll break this a little bit down one more time. So after that second cut, tip, land, toe, hop, tip. And fast, that will be. Okay. Mary says, bless you, thank you.
I think the thunderstorm is Zully getting hungry. Carl, no, don't say that, Jason. It's hay fever.
It's hay fever. Let's do Robo Jake up to there, up to where we've learned it, okay? 3, 2, 1, go. Everyone got that? And from behind. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay? I'll do it one more time and I'll just go on to the next little bit so I know what comes next. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. Let's just do the next bit because it's easy. So after I'm toe, do we toe? Wait. Yes, the next bit's super easy. So I'll just do it before I read your comments. So we've done this bit. This was the bit we were breaking out a few minutes ago. The next bit is step back. Okay, so. Okay, and toe, do the toe, hop, bang. Okay, from the front. And toe, do the toe, that's where we got up to. Then you step back on your back, on your left leg, bang, with the right leg, and do another cut. So. And toe, do the toe, hop, bang. So you do a cut before the bang, and a cut after it. So. Toe, do the toe, that's where we got up to before. Step, bang. Okay. Toe, hop, bang. We're going to jump off the ground. So one more time, well, let's just do it up to there with that new bang after it, and then I'll read your comments. So 3, 2, 1, go. Woohoo! And from behind, 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, rightio. let me sit down, read some comments,
and talk to you guys. You guys let me know what you want me to do as well, remember? It's like an episode of Black Mirror, you control me. If you want me to move on or leave it there, do something else, let me know. For anyone who is just tuned in, we'll have another quick recap of what we do, because I know people kind of tune in at different times. What we do here, with me, it's a dance class, basically. Fun. The main idea is fun. We start off the class with a trick of the day, where I'll teach you something that's not from the show, something that's not very traditional, a bit more tappy, something that you probably wouldn't have learned from your other dance classes, because it's all about fun here. That's the main thing. And that's what we do. We start off the class, so we learn a new trick every day. And hopefully down the line, we'll stick them all together into a little routine. Then we, in the middle section, we learn something from the show, what we're doing right now. Today we're learning Robo Jig, because that's what you guys asked for in the stream. And then at the end, we'll play this game called Guess the Dance, where I'll cover the webcam. I'll dance a couple of bars from a number from the show, and you guys have to guess by just listening what the dance is. But yeah, I'm going to read a few comments here. If I've missed a few, please just repost them, because I can't go back too far here. As you can see on the screen, only a few come up. Sarah asks, have I missed Guess the Dance? No, Sarah. See, like I said, people just tune in at different times. No, Sarah, you haven't missed Guess the Dance. That is coming up soon. Jason, when this is all over, will you do live streams at live shows again? That's a question for Jason. Yes, he will. Excuse me. Sorry, my throat is dry. On YouTube, Gloria says, thank you for tonight. I hope you have a great week. I watched your show in Galway. Greetings from Holland. Yes, and people were asking earlier on, I shared a video there a few days ago, was looking for that trick of the day we done, the energy saver step. It's you can see me and my bro do it in that video that I shared. A bit of fun, a bit of jamming out on stage. Nicholas, jazz shoes are kind of West End shows. Well, they are for a performance in the West End, yes. But yeah, rightio. Who's ready to continue with learning the rest of this step? We'll finish off this step, and if you want to learn it next week as well, just let me know and we can continue on Robojig. Robojig's a hard dance, by the way. The steps are quite hard. But let's do up to where we've got so far. Okay. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, this next thing is very, very funky. It goes, so we've done the and bang step. Now this next move, I'm not gonna lie, I think it is quite hard. I'll try my best to break it down. Can you do Lord of the Dance steps next week? Yes, let me know guys, write in here in the chat what you want me to do next week. This is quite a hard dance. So we're gonna go. Okay, so this next bit is very funky. It goes, well I think it is anyway, we go. We bring this leg back kind of like this, a bit like a horse type of style, very old fashioned Irish dancing. And we do that, so that's, we do land with the left leg, tip, heel. So you're just kind of falling down onto it. Okay, so we'll do the little bit forward. Okay, it looks hard actually, it's not that hard when I break it down. Here we go, so we're going to jump, land on the left leg, and then land on the right toe, and then the right heel. So you just kind of fall back onto it. There's three beats, okay? 1, 2, 3, okay? 1, 2, 3, but they're really quick. So after the... Okay. Okay. And we continue on. So... After that, we're going to do a tip with their left leg. So that goes, do a tip with the left leg, tip, land, bang. And that's a really funny bang too. These are kind of old style steps. So usually, when I was taught bangs anyway, it was all kind of, everything was kind of kept under me. But this is like a kind of, and we're doing a bang and then stepping onto it. So we've gone with three beats, then tip,
and bang. Okay, we'll do that slow a few times. I'll do it from behind, so here we go. All the way on your left leg. Hop, tip, heel. Wait. Yeah, sorry. Hop, tip, heel. Tip, hop, okay? Okay. Sorry, I'm getting tired. I'm finding it hard to break these down. And again, so here we go. Hop, tip, heel. Tip, hop. Does that make sense? I hope it does. From behind, all the way, start with all the weights on your left leg, and we go hop, tip, heel, tip, hop, bang. Okay. Any Irish dancers, like I've said before, will know it's quite hard breaking it down. It's fast, this step looks like this. Okay. Try it slow again. Here we go. All the weight on your left leg. Hop, tip, heel. So that, you just kind of think of that as like falling down onto it. So we've done the hop and now we're transferring your weight from a left to a right. And like I said before, when you're transferring weight, you can do it by one, just one beat or else two beats by going through the tip first. So tip, heel. Then we're going to go tip, step. Bang it. It's a funny bang, kind of kicking through. Bang. And all together, it's like this. Who's ready to try it from the start up to there? 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, it's quite hard to break down slow. I'll do it from the front again. 3, 2, 1, go. Let's read a few comments. A couple of quad clicks there. Hey. How's everyone getting on? Gemma said she wants to learn four lads next week. Yes, definitely. We haven't done that, so that is a good suggestion. We could do four lads next week. Carol says, yes. You mentioned these steps more old style. Yes. What's some of the biggest differences versus new style? Very, very good question. Let me try to explain. Even though I didn't really learn much old style myself. So even when I was competing, the old style was kind of gone. I never really done traditional sets. I learned a St. Patrick's Day, which is a traditional set, but that was all I learned. Recently, when I finished competing, they started bringing back traditional set dances. I know the competitive dancers had to do like the All-Ireland and stuff, so they've started learning a lot of traditional moves. So I'm not the best at telling you about the old moves, but kind of an example would be, like, in Four Lads, this would be I would have never learned this when I was dancing, but I would have seen it in a lot of old videos. You know in Four Lads when they do it, when they hit the tap off the heel? So in Four Lads, it's like, okay, it's quite hard. Like, those things are quite old style moves. Stuff like this, that's quite an old style move. Apart from like the jump double kick at the start, that would be just a regular standard traditional Irish dance move. But stuff like this, I'd find that is quite an old type of rhythm. The new style, which I mostly learned, was a lot more upright, a lot more legs crossed, and you know, they still have all their usual traditional stuff, but we would have been doing some not traditional moves with our legs crossed. So like we would still keep our legs crossed, but we could have been going. So that would be kind of a lot more the new style. It looks a little bit in competition, obviously, you still got to keep your legs crossed. I know I'm not keeping my hands on my side. It's been a while. We do this in Lord of the Dance. But you still got to keep your legs crossed. And that would be kind of an example of the more new style. It's kind of harder. Well, I don't know if it's harder, because some of the old style is hard, but the old style would be like a a bit more kind of bendy knees.
I don't know if I explained that very well. I probably didn't. I apologize. But I think that in RoboJig is a bit old style. I found it hard anyway when I was learning it. Where am I? Jason was asking that. Is there a difference in weight of Warriors costumes to RoboJig costumes? Or do they feel the same weight-wise? Is there a difference? Yeah, I don't know which ones are heavier. Maybe the RoboJig ones are heavier. Yeah, I would say the RoboJig ones are heavier. RoboJig ones are a lot less comfortable, I can tell you that. How's everyone getting on? Let me know. What do you want me to do? On YouTube, Ella says, awesome, and emoji faces. Nice one. Yeah, let me know. Will we continue on learning RoboJig? I think we will.
We'll finish the step and then we'll play Guess the Dance. What time are we at? Oh, yeah. We'll finish this RoboJig step quickly. So let's dance it up today. We finish with the... So, bang, land, and shuffle, hop back. So we've done shuffle, hop back loads of times, okay? Mary says yes to continue on. Okay, good. Oh, let me stretch out. Like I said, I'm a bit stiff from all my running. So let's do it from the start up to the... Okay, so 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, let's dance that from behind and then we will move on. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, how's everyone getting on? I just thought of something. Jason was asking, what's the old style? I would have thought a lot of this kind of movement with the leg is very old style-y. I wouldn't have done much of that when I was competing, so I just noticed everyone were doing it. What is it? That, I would have thought that was kind of old styling. Anyways, one more time to the front and then we'll move on. The next bit's actually not too hard. So here we go, last time from the front. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, next bit, they just kick out. We go, slam, kick, and. So 3 kick outs, and we finish with a bang. So we go, start with a bang on the left leg, bang. Kick, land, down, kick, land, down, kick, land, bang, bang. If that makes sense. My floor is slipping backwards. Here we go. So we go, bang, kick, up, land, kick, up, land, kick, up, bang. So that's just, I think it's quite easy. Stamp with this leg, kick through, and go, kick, land, land. So separate the land, don't land together. Separate. We're landing with 2 legs because we're in the air for a split second like this. So when you land, go 1, 2. Don't go like this. That doesn't sound good for this stance anyway. So we're going to go kick, land, land, kick, land, land, kick. Does that make sense? And again. Bang, kick, up, down, kick, up, down, kick, up, down. I think that bit's quite easy. I'll do it 2 more times. We've gone. Okay. And any Irish dancers there should know you should be pointing your toes and kicking your legs straight. I know I'm not, but I'm allowed to take it easy. How's everyone getting on? We do that one more. We'll do it from the start up to the end of those kicks. And then we'll move on to the next bit, which is... Yes, Jason was asking about old style. Me, personally, I could be wrong. I don't want to get given out to by any of the old school dancers if they're watching. I would have thought this would have been quite an old style move. I know I definitely didn't learn that until I came to the show. What we don't know is Conal's emoji is actually moving. So we try from the start to the end of those kickouts. and then we'll go into the next bit. So from the start up to there, 3, 2, 1, go. How's everyone getting on? Let me know. No questions in about the steps.
Can you do partner dances, or is that different style of Irish dancing? Partner dances, do you mean ceilidhs? That's another thing that I unfortunately missed out on. I never done ceilidhs. Is it very effective? It's very effective, and I think it's pretty clear. Rightio. Deborah says, guess the dance, question mark. Okay, Deborah, people won't guess the dance. Okay, we will do guess the dance. Yeah? Yes or no? We've got a few seconds. Will we do guess the dance, or will we do this next step?
Let me just see. Yeah, we'll do guess the dance. Because this next bit is... It's quite hard, and all a robo jig is quite hard, I think. So if you can get up to here... Sorry, Deborah's answered.
And told me what to do. We were moving on to guess the dance, Deborah. You were right. This is quite a hard dance, so what we've done so far is hard. Let's do it 3 times, okay? Nicholas says yes for guess the dance. Someone else saying woohoo. Everyone wants guess the dance. We're going to play that now in literally 1 minute time. I'm just going to do this 3 more times. Oh, everyone wants guess the dance. Okay, I'll do it twice. We'll do it just twice. Twice more for anyone who wants to dance along with me.
Okay? And then I promise we're going to do guess the dance. So all the way up to those kickouts. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. And last time. And then we're going to do guess the dance. 3, 2, 1, go.
That's the end of Robo Jig. And now we're moving on to guess the dance.
Yeah.
Someone says, ever lost a tap on stage. Yes, and I'm kind of losing a heel here.
Let me just get a bit of tape. Have I ever lost a tap?
I've got a good story about a tap. And this is really nerdy, but I was super proud of it. I can't remember who was dancing lead. But their tap came off anyway. That's not important in this story. I was doing backline, and whoever was lead, the tap came off and was at the front of the stage. And anyone who knows run on,
so I seen the tap. I was coming on stage left. Okay? So pretend this whole square is the stage, okay? Obviously I'll have to move really slowly. And we're coming out the back curtain here, and the tap was about there. So I knew, I was like, I need to get that tap off stage. So I was like, I could kick it off the front of the stage, but I knew the person doing lead might want the tap. So I was like, if I could kick it into the wings. So coming out, we do this step. Around in a circle. And I got to about this side of the stage. So coming back the way I went like this. And I was at the tap. And I went. And I kicked it into the wing. So if the tap was on the stage there, I was like. And I was super proud of that. So that's not me losing the tap. Someone asked, did I lose a tap? But when someone else did, I was very happy with that moment. I got it. Kicked it right off the stage. Stage right. Anyways, we're going to be playing Guess the Dance. Okay, so we're coming towards the end of the stream. For anyone who what did Lord of the Dance say there? Tap goes flying like a hockey puck. Exactly. It was like a hockey puck right into the wings. And obviously, whoever was lead could go off. Got their tap, got it fixed before the next bit. For anyone who's just tuned in, what we do here, we started off the class and we learned the trick of the day. In this Guess the Dance, I will throw in the trick of the day. So for anyone who's just tuned in, this is what the trick of the day sounds like, okay? I'm not going to be breaking it down, we've done that at the start, but this is what it sounds like.
because when I'm throwing it into this Guess the Dance, you'll have to listen out for it.
So this is what the trick of the day sounded like.
So that was the trick of the day, so you're going to have to listen out to that as well, because I will throw it in at some stage. But apart from that, everything else I'll be dancing is from the show. So, yeah, here we go.
Let's just jump right into it.
So I'm going to cover the webcam, okay? Anyone who hasn't played this before, I cover the webcam. You've got to keep listening, so turn your volume up. I'm going to dance something from the show. You have to tell me what dance this is from the show. So round one of Guess the Dance. Here we go. What dance, what number from the show is this? 3, 2, 1, go. Quite an unusual one today, right? Listen carefully. That rhythm, what dance from the show is it, okay? I'll do it again. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, I think this could be a hard one. What dance from the show is that? I see a right answer already. I am sweating now. Oh my god, everyone seems to be getting this. I'll give you another few seconds. Okay, a lot of people said Nightmare, and the answer is Nightmare. Coming out the curtains, you know. Very good. I'll show you what it looks like. So that was round one. Everyone seemed to get that one right.
A lot of people anyway. It's there.
Okay, good. Okay, who's ready for round two? Round two of Guess the Dance. What am I going to do? I know. What dance from the show? What dance is this from? Here we go, round two.
Okay, what dance is this from? I'll do it again. Okay. And I'll do it one more time.
Hard one. I didn't do much that time. What dance is that from? Sarah's straight in there. How are you getting on, Sarah? I didn't know if you were still in the chat or not. How did you get on with those steps, Sarah? Let me know. Robojig was hard today, but how did you get on with the Cathal's trick of the day at the stair? I think it was quite easy. A few answers coming in here. Encore Planet Ireland. That's the same dance. If anyone wants is confused, we have multiple names for the dances in the show. As if it wasn't confusing enough. Three Lords and Encore. Oh, very good. Someone says Turkey in the Straw. I don't know what that is. Oh, is that like what I was saying last week, the way we often used to come up with funny names for a big group of steps? Some more people said Encore. Yes, it is Encore. That is Encore. That rhythm pattern was from. Rightio. I'm going to go on to the next one. Round three of Guess the Dance. What will I do? Had to nip out and eat some dinner, Sarah said, so I missed most of Robojig. Robojig was hard, but doing okay with the tricks. Thanks for asking. And that is good to hear. Planet Ireland, Mary says. Yes, you're right, Mary. It is Planet Ireland. And someone says Encore. Yes. That one was from Encore. Okay, next one. What am I going to do next? Let me think. I had one earlier that Oh, yes. This one. There's double points for this. This rhythm pattern I'm about to do is in two dances in the show, okay? It's in two. If you can guess me what two dances this is from.
I think you'll get this one. So, the next... This is round three, I think. Someone says, I'm getting addicted to this game. Okay. Another viewer, TV. That is good to hear. Anyways, so... Guess round three. This one, this rhythm pattern I'm about to do is in two dances. If you can tell me what two dances it's from, I'll be very impressed. Okay?
Here we go. This is in two dances. Here we go. And again, here we go. Hey, it's a short rhythm pattern, but it's in two dances in the show. One more time.
What two dances is that from? Oh! I am very, very impressed with some people. Yes, getting the Facebook up. Got a lot of people on Facebook tonight. That's good. I'm liking it. Yes, a few answers coming in. Lord of the Dance Duel, Lord of the Dance Duel, LOTD, which is also Lord of the Dance, obviously. Duel, Duel and Lord of the Dance. Yes! You're all right. That is, we do it in Lord of the Dance, obviously coming across the stage. It's kind of like what Fergal's, my brother's doing there in the poster. We're going... But then we also do that same rhythm pattern in duo when we're pushing the bad guy. And that's when we punch him in the face.
Very impressed with everyone.
Oh, nice one. I hope I didn't crack the tile there. No, I didn't. It's okay.
Deborah says, duo. Yes, Deborah, you were right. And it's also in Lord of the Dance. In the solo. Who's ready for round four? Round four of Guess the Dance. Sarah Dean says, Jewel and LOTD. You are absolutely correct. Well done, Sarah. I'm surprised. Well done. I thought that was going to be a hard one. I also thought the execution steps at the start, because they're quite different. I didn't think people would get that, but I am very, very impressed today. Okay. Will we move on to the next round? Hope everyone's having a good time. Oh, sorry, I'll just get the stream up here on the Facebook. Yeah, having a good time. Check me out, Facebook, Instagram, like and subscribe. Isn't that what all the YouTubers say? Here we go, round four. Guess the dance. Okay. Oh, here we go.
The dance one more time.
Da, 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 da. Mm-hmm. It looks like everyone's got that one. That was the trick one. Yes, I'm just watching the comments coming here because I'm a few seconds ahead of you guys. Everyone is right. It is trick of the day, guys. Flips tricks. It's what I taught you at the very start of class. I thought I'd catch you out with that one. The solo trick, Mary says on Facebook. Yes. Sign for the guest to dance. Yeah, everyone is getting this one. Trick of the day. Hey, very good. Okay, guys, last one. This is the last round of Guess the Dance. And then you can just ask me any questions and we'll have a little chat before we finish up. So last round of Guess the Dance, okay? Here we... Can you make a better... What? Can I make a better sign? Why, what's wrong? Can you see through it? Wait, maybe... It isn't a great sign, is it? No. We love the sign. I will agree with you, Gemma. It is not the best sign. I do apologize. But hey, it's not about the sign. It's about the game and having fun. Anyways, I will make a better one, don't worry. But yes, that last one was actually a trick question. It was the move I taught you at the start of the stream from the trick of the day. So guys, last round. Guess the dance, and then we'll have a little chat, and then we'll finish up. Guess the dance.
Hey, this is the last one. Guess the dance. Here we go. Okay, and again, guess the dance. 3, 2, 1, go. That's the last round, guys.
Rightio, rightio. Yes, I would expect everyone to get this, and it looks like you're. Someone's at it. A lot of right answers coming in. Everyone is getting good at this game. At the start, we'd have a good few rounds where most people would get it wrong. It was Robojig, guys. The answer was Robojig, the step we were just learning. I thought you'd all recognize it. Most of you got it right. Nice one. Olivia says, hey, my girlfriend's in. Olivia says, I like the sign. Thank you. It isn't the most amazing sign in the world. Maybe we can get Joe. We can get Joe on his arts and craft time to make me a new sign. How about that? That could be interesting. But yes, guys, so the answer to that last one was, yeah, Nicholas. Yes, red coats would also be accepted. Winky face. Yes, Nicholas. Flips, we are your top class, so we know most of your steps. Yes, you were. After lockdown, Cathal sign the sign and guess the dance sign and give it to a person with the most points. Yes. Yes. I will do that. I will sign the guess the dance sign and I'll post it out to someone at the end of this lockdown. So you can just private message me your address at the end of this and I will send it to you. And you can have guess the sign. Oh, yes. Hey, modern art is all about simplicity, okay? To Banksy. Anyways, guys, we will finish up the dancing stuff today. If anyone has any questions, let me know. Ask me whatever you want to ask. Go ahead and ask it, and I'll answer. And, yeah. And please, everyone, tune in next week, because next week we'll do the same thing. We'll learn a new trick, okay? We'll learn a new trick, something different and funky. Today, the trick we learned was quite an easy low to the ground. I called it an energy saver move. It's one of these moves you're throwing into the middle of a dance or a routine to get your energy back, but while still keeping the rhythm going. If you look at any of Michael Flatley's solos, like Feet of Flames, he himself will even throw in one of these energy saver moves, you know? It's basically, you slow it down, it doesn't take too much energy out of it, and you obviously just can't stop and stand there on stage, but you're still dancing, but you're kind of getting your energy back, you know? So it's a quite important move, and I would recommend everyone try and learn it. There's loads of them out there, but I think it was a fun one we learned today. So yeah, every week we learn a new trick, and the goal is that in a couple of weeks' time, live on one of these streams, we will make up a live solo, and hopefully we will throw in all these tricks that we've learned, along with some other traditional Irish dance moves, where the legs are more crossed and stuff. But it's always fun to throw in a few funky, tappy stuff as well. I've just kind of got lost in my thoughts there. But yeah, I'm sorry. So yeah, tune in next week. We'll do the same thing. We will learn a new trick. Then we will learn a dance from Lord of the Dance. Let me know what you want to learn in the chat room here before I go. Do you want to continue on with Robo Jig, or do you want to learn any other dance from the show? Let me know and I can teach it to you guys. And then we'll finish up every week with that game, Guess the Dance. So we've got three things that happen in these streams. It's a little bit of fun. Trick of the day, learn some dances from Lord of the Dance, and we play Guess the Dance at the end. And it's all about fun here, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. But yeah, fire any questions. My name is Cathal Keaney. So yeah, fire any questions you have for me. Carol has asked, can we do Four Lads? We sure can. We haven't done that one yet. That would be a good dance to do. Who knows, maybe Cathal is Banksy. I could be Banksy. You never know. Thank you. Looking forward to next time. You're very welcome. What's your favourite costume in the show? Maybe the run-on costume, especially when we have the belt that Flatley used to wear. Would probably be the run-on costume as lead. That would be my favourite one, Gemma. Mary votes for victory. We've got some people asking for victory and Four Lads. Okay. Sorry. Do you like going to the pub? Yes, I do like going to the pub, but there is no pub open right now. How many rolls of Marley would you need to cover the whole Lord of the Dance stage? I'm not too sure. Like, is it 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 rolls maybe? They have 6 rolls that go across. Our stage changes when we're on tour. But yeah, about 6 rolls. Basically, the Lord of the Dance stage is pretty much, see what I have here? Obviously, this is blue, but that is basically what the Lord of the Dance stage is, except a lot bigger, yeah? This portal of song is the same. It's a sprung floor with wood for the nice sound, with a non-slip polymer overlay, also called Merrily, on top. So that's pretty much the same as the Lord of the Dance stage, and it would probably take 6 rolls. Let me know if anyone has any more questions. What's your favourite Irish tune? Lord of the Dance. Someone says, see you next week. Any other suggestions on what dance we should learn next week? Let me know. And I'm looking forward to making up the solo live on air. It'll be interesting, won't it? What will you say to your younger self? Ooh, that's a very deep question, Ruben. What would I say? Probably just, I don't know, just in general, not in dancing terms, would just be enjoy every moment and try not get too worked up about anything. I feel like sometimes we get stressed out about situations, and I'm sure everyone has something in their past that they got stressed out about, and looking back on it now, they're like, why did I give it so much energy?
So that would be my advice. And Nicholas says, I am still young. Quite, thank you very much. How many steps do you do in total in Lord of the Dance? Oh God, I don't know. I'm sorry, I can't answer that. It's in the hundreds of thousands. Flips, did you know that on the 19th June, Twitch will be 1 year old, as was the date that Jason used to join us in Athens? 1 year! Could that be a good day to make up the solo on the 1 year anniversary? Maybe. Will we have enough steps learned by then? But we could. We could do that. Maybe. Could be an idea. But on the 19th of June, we will be 1 year old on Twitch. So yeah, guys, if anyone doesn't know what we do here, we're live on 3 platforms. So we're live on Twitch, we're live on Facebook, and we're live on YouTube. Go follow us on all those social media. My name is Cathal Keaney. You can follow me, guys, on Instagram and stuff if you want to check out what I get up to. But yeah, we do this every week. We're live streaming on 3 platforms, Twitch, Facebook, and YouTube. So make sure you check out Lord of the Dance on those platforms and check out Cathal Keaney. Sarah said, I wouldn't mind going over some of the encore steps. We did the first part, but there are lots more. Yes, there is lots more. So we've done a lot of dances here, but we've kind of been chopping and changing because I just want to keep you all guys interested. But if there's anything you want to go back to, we can do that. While on tour, do you take your portable sprung floor to practice? Believe it or not at the moment, but we did for a while. If anyone wants to check out, it's on Lord of the Dance's page as well. It's quite far back, but on the Portable Sprung Floors page, we made a video. It's about a 2-minute long video. It's on our Facebook and Instagram, and where we took around the board, and you can see like a lot of the dancers from Lord of the Dance, like Niall who was not in the show anymore, was in it. Olivia, Fran Dunn, Declan Durney, Bondi. We travelled to about 15 countries with the Portable Sprung Floor,
And yeah, but we don't have one at the moment, unfortunately. But yeah, we did take one on tour. We need a Twitch party. Yes, we do. Hi, Carl. Just arrived home from Irish step dance lessons. Hope you're doing awesome. Greetings from Budapest. Oh, hello. And you had classes already in Budapest. Nice. Rightio. I think we will leave it at that today. I hope everyone had fun. I hope everyone please come and tune in next Wednesday at the same time. Do you think Michael might consider popping online for the one-year celebration? I don't know. That is something we will have to get onto Jason for. He might be able to organize that. That could be pretty fun. Yes, hey guys, look, I won't dilly-dally any longer. Hope you all had fun today. Please check us out on all the social media. Follow Lord of the Dance. Follow me. If you have any questions, be thinking about it, and you can ask me next week. And yeah, please check us out next week on the stream. And we'll do the same thing. We'll learn a new trick of the day. We'll learn something new from the show. We can decide at the start of the next stream. You guys can keep running in. At the moment, we have Encore, Robo Jig, and Victory, and four lads that people want to learn. And we'll also play another round of Guess the Dance. But yeah, adios, guys. I'm going to leave it there.